Hi,
Karthik.
I'm Kar. So about myself, about my experience, worked with the HANA database studio, especially for this modeling, data modeling, as per the client requirements. It's around 1.5 year, and BW powered by HANA. That is one project. That is around 9 months. That is my experience in SAP. So now I would like to move to this cloud integration. It's very something new compared to this present time.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, but around 2 years of experience in SAP, 2.5 years of experience.
So still, I would say beginners phase of SAP. Anyway, Pradeep.
Hi, so I'm having 11 years of experience in SAP,
How many?
so 3 years of
11.
experience, 11,
Yep, okay.
3 years of experience in ABAP, and the rest all with the SAP RPA and PO. So I
Okay.
certified in Dell Bumi too, so I work for a couple of projects in Dell Bumi.
Okay. Okay. And you are based out of India?
Right now I am in US.
Okay. Yes. Sairam?
Yeah, hi Sanath. Good evening. This is Sairam
Good
Shukla.
evening.
I'm having 7 years of experience. I'm completely into XI and PI PO last 7 years. I'm
Okay.
completely new to this HCI. I'm from
So,
Hyderabad.
yeah, nice. Yeah, Vijay. Vijay, can you unmute yourself? I guess. Arvind, are you? Will you be able to speak now?
Yeah. Rejoined actually, so that's why I'm not able to speak in that time. Are you able to hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah. Hi, Samar. I'm having 11 plus years of experience, on which 9 plus years experience. I mean, to completely into SAP PA. I was completely into that like implementation products only. So I want to see about the HCA. As of now, just want to see my skills exposure on that HCA. So that's why I'm learning.
Nice. So majorly people are from SAP background. Not sure about Vijay. If Vijay can unmute him, try to speak, please. Anyway, anyway, anyway. So yes. So nice to hear that everybody is from SAP background. I mean, they are SAP literate as of now. So it's not that we have to start from scratch for what is SAP and where exactly SAP resides in your enterprise landscape. So I would be directly jumping on to the content right now. Okay. Let me know if you can see my screen. I have shared, means on my screen is the PDF of SAP Cloud Integration Curriculum. Is it visible?
Yeah, it's visible now.
So quickly going through the curriculum. Yes, so you can see it is just introduction to HANA Cloud Integration. I would start with little bit more of what is SOA generally, what is SOA and what is your middlewares. Okay, because there are some type of people who are don't know exactly what are middlewares and what are SOA and what exactly your middleware resides in the HCI landscape. So we will start from there. Then we will jump on to introduction of HANA Cloud Integration. what are the capabilities of cloud. When I say cloud, there would be different offerings of SAP. You have the SuccessFactors, you have CS4, you have the C4C. So there are so many things in the market which are based on the cloud. Okay, so we will see the capabilities of cloud, then we will understand what is cloud integration. You have a HANA cloud integration, which is further divided into two parts. You have the data integration and process integration. We will be mainly concentrating on the process integration part, not the data integration part. Data integration part is something your kind of data services. If you have ever heard of BODS, so that is also included in SAP, but in our training we will be purely concentrating on the PI part, the process integration part, or in other words, the transactional data which is transferred from our system. Looking into that, we will be understanding the So we will be understanding architecture, overview, what are technical systems, what are network architecture, what are different data centers in terms of SAP HCI, what are secure communication. Okay. Then we will be understanding different web UI cloud tools. You have the web UI, okay, you have the Eclipse platform, you have the cloud platform, HANA cloud platform, and you have the cloud connector. So before running our first integration scenario in the cloud and your web UI or your Eclipse UI, we will understand what exactly web UI is or Eclipse UI is, how to install that, how to install the plugins for your HCI into that. Okay, then we will be jumping on to creation of our first scenario in the HCI, and that first scenario would be the prepackaged content or something like that. It would be purely triggered through your SOAP UI or something like that. So you will see your SAP HCI also supports SOAP UI or Boomerang for the matter of fact, which allow you to send data to HCI and get the response. So again, we will see those portion in the later classes. Okay. Then we will understand the integration content catalog, what are the prepackaged content, configuration, how to configure prepackaged content. It would be kind of an overview, and in the later classes we will understand and we will customize those. Okay, in the later classes. Okay. When you create your first integration scenario, it will be covering up the creation of your own content packages. So that would be again done, and we will see these things both on your web UI as well as Eclipse UI. It's not that we will be only looking into things into your Eclipse UI. Kind of there are two, I mean, just I'm deviating from the topic. There are two ways to configure all the scenarios in your HCI. It is either through your Eclipse or through your web UI. So Eclipse, what it gives you means Eclipse is a kind of an offline tool where you can create all your scenarios, all the things, and then you can deploy it on the web UI, on the tenant of HCI. And web UI is always an online tool on which you can create your scenarios, which you can configure your scenarios, you can monitor scenarios. It's not that it is in Eclipse. That thing is also possible in Eclipse, but Eclipse is quite fast and kind of my personally I like Eclipse more because it is quite fast as compared to your web UI. So we will be understanding both the cases in this. Okay, so creating our own packages on Eclipse as well as on your web UI, creating our iFlows on both. Okay, and designing develop integration flows, we will understanding what is camel message model, content enrichment means, and there are some things called content enrichment or something message transformation. So these are the basic tools which are present, or you can say events which are present in the HCI. Okay, you have the data transformation, mapping, content-based routing, working with the list. So all these things I will be covering up in one session, one session. Okay, for message persistence and message container, I will be taking separately one class, because those are the new features which are available in the HCI as compared to your PI. In your PI, these features are not available. So we will be specifically looking into this message persistent, message container. Okay. Then we will be understanding what are Groovy script, how to create a Groovy script. We will see a simple scenario to use that Groovy script to get the details of the tenant. Okay, so that would be one more scenario. It's triggering the message and getting a response. So we will be understanding through that to Groovy script. Okay, kind of the Groovy script, and you have JavaScript. So most probably we will be using Groovy script in exception handling. Okay, then session specifically for the adapter, cloud adapters, which adapters are available. You have Soup, you have SuccessFactor, Mail, Twitter, OData, iDoc, HTTP, SFTP, Ariba. Okay, and there are two more adapters which are recently joined in this fee, which are LDAP adapter, okay, and one is ODC adapter. So ODC adapter is again for the OData, kind of OData itself, but it's newer one. Okay, you have the, and there is an LDAP adapter which is specifically for the Active Directory. People from the Dell Bumi can relate to this. Okay. So, and then you have the developing customer adapter. I have a document for what exactly custom adapter, how to, what are the steps to create your custom adapter. Generally, this is least required, creating your own adapter, because the standard functionality and the standard features, and also major of the integration is covered by this standard adapters. You have OData and you have Soap, where you will cover 60% of the market available integration means options. So you have Soap, you have OData, and you have the SFTP. These three are will be the major one, and which are the most vital one, which are used. Okay. As of now, there is no A2A adapter or B2B adapter provided in your HCI as of now. I'm saying till date, it's not there. You don't have the EDI adapter, or you have A2A, B2B, A2A or B2B kind of adapters, which you used to do with the configuration in your PI, your EDI separator, and all those things. These are not available. So it's kind of a drawback for the HCI, but you can say your SAP is also not willing to develop those adapters, because they don't want to bring so much diversity, and they want to keep all the softwares as standard as possible, because this would be very specific for EDI, and those things would be specific. So SAP is now, they will develop it or not, it's kind of confusion as of now, because in some roadmap it was said that they will be working in the EDI adapter, and recently the recent roadmap there is nothing specified about the EDI adapter. So we can say that as of now it's not coming in with recent releases, the upcoming releases, but hope so they will bring the EDI adapter, because company or your some specific software, some specific integration is not done by your this standard adapters. Anyway, then we will be going with the SAP cloud integration operation, means message monitoring, message processing, messaging, manage integration content, managing security material, managing certificate to user mapping. So all these things we will be covering in our integration operation. Okay, we will be understanding what are the different security levels. Okay, you have the transport level security, you have the message level security, data protection, data flow security, certificate based communication. I will be covering certificate based communication in one separate session or one or separate session, because it is certificate based communication, private key and public key. So I will be giving the details on those separately. Okay, you have the basic cryptography authentication or OAuth scenario, user administration authorization. I will be giving you an overview on that. But certificate based communication, private key and public key certificates, I will be giving a detailed description. Okay, then you have the enhancements. This enhancement, I will show you what is transport management. Transport management generally we relate to transporting our artifacts from one system to other system. When I say artifacts, in the on-premises universe, it is something called our objects. So any objects which we have created in on-premises, let's say in PI, so to move from one system to another system, we have a transport mechanism. So we will see what transport mechanism is available in HCI. Is there any transport mechanism available or not? Okay. Payload monitoring, trace function. It's payload monitoring, how to do payload monitoring, how it is possible, what you have the trace function, the hybrid development, what exactly hybrid development is. And in real-time scenario, rather than this, I will be giving the document for this, the building the new interface from SFSF to ECC HR system configuration, the ECCN, okay. New interface for SFSF to SFTP. Rather than SFSF, I will be taking up the C4C. SFSF also I will be showing all the things, and with C4C I will be showing the live scenarios. Okay, and in that also we will see configuration required at the ECC and at the C4C and at the HCIN. Okay, and all those things will be covered. What are cloud connectors and all those things would be covered there itself. Okay, so this is our brief, what you get, the curriculum, or which would be going through in our tenure of our training. Okay, any questions till now for this? If you have any questions, tell me, else I will start the session with the our SOA middleware. What exactly SOA is, and what is our middleware SAR? And please keep the session as interactive as possible. Don't think of it. Don't wait for me to ask for something. You can just stop me and ask the question. Keep the session interactive so that other participants also are getting knowledge of what means they are. If there is a query in their mind also, if they are not asking, you should ask, so that the things would be cleared. And then
yeah,
someone was speaking, sir.
Samat Arun here.
Who are you?
Yeah. Here, Samat. Like in
when do we get this SAP HCI access, server access?
Like in
SAP HCI access, it could be tough for me to give because it's my client related HCI. So,
we want to do some hands-on, right? So,
yes, sir.
For that.
Yes, sir. There is an alternative to this. You can download Eclipse on your local. You can install plugins for the HCI in that. Okay. Just showing you, and don't get confused. I'm just showing you for the sake of your question. Okay, so just install your HCI plugins to Eclipse, and you have all the features which are available in your HCI UI, web UI, are available in your Eclipse UI also. So you don't require the Eclipse HCI tenant. You would be able to configure all the scenarios. You won't be able to deploy the scenarios. That is one drawback. but you will be able to get all the features and explore all the features which are available in your HCI directly in your Eclipse, and it does not require your S user ID or any SCN ID also. So it is directly which you can use, okay, and you can do the practice, and I will be giving you assignments, and I will be asking for the zip file which if you have created or not. So I will be keeping you people on to, I will be giving you assignments, and I will be expecting those assignments before my next session, means before moving to the next session, I will be expecting those assignments to be completed. Okay. And those assignments you need to mail to Bharat, and Bharat will mail to me all those assignments. And I will import those assignments into my Eclipse, and I will deploy those to my HCI tenant. So there you can see. But without your access to HCI also, you can configure all the scenarios because you have the access of everything in your Eclipse. Okay, I will be taking a separate class altogether to how to configure your Eclipse. So don't worry about that, how we will do that and all that. I will be doing that. Okay.
Yeah, you want to see that in like in SAP. SAP environment, how it will look like when you're after deploying into the HCI tenant from the Eclipse. You want to see that how it looks like in those screens.
Yeah, yeah. So you will be able to see here itself. If you ask me, it will be directly, you will be able to see all those scenarios, whatever you have deployed, it will be available here. So it won't be a big task. The big task is configuring the scenario and removing the errors. Okay, and that is
okay.
That is not dependent on your HCI tenant access. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. You're getting me. Means deploying is the next target of first of all removing the errors. Okay. Your Eclipse also itself gives an error before deploying that this is not possible and this is possible, and whatever it is, on saving and on executing checks. Okay. Getting me, sir?
Hello?
Yeah,
yes,
I'm
sir.
Getting that.
Yeah, who's this?
Yeah, I'm Karthik.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, is there any problem with, giving the server access to hands-on experience?
This is my user, means this is my client HCI tenant, so it would be very tough for me because I cannot add directly users here.
Okay. So the thing you were mentioning that so we would work out on the Eclipse environment, right? So is it the same way we can, get the skills as like you practiced in our real-time scenario?
I do all the configuration on Eclipse itself, I would be very frank.
Yeah, is there any deviation from the server access to the working with Eclipse?
No, there is only one deviation is that this tenant which you have on the your left side, this is the thing which won't be available in your case. Apart from this, everything means you are monitoring. If you are doing a monitoring of your messages, let's say I'm monitoring my messages. So this thing is not available in your case when you don't have the server access. Apart from this, everything is available.
Okay. After our complete sessions, we can reach the outcome from outcome from me is as same as in the HCI server access, right? Both are same, nothing but here you have shown URL is not possible to get this thing, right, in Eclipse?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Can we check all the errors here?
Hello? One at a time, sir. Who was,
you
just speak first, let's complete your question.
Yeah, see, like you do one thing then. So you explain us all the scenarios. It's a tenant, and we will do a hard practice in Eclipse.
Yes.
Like that we'll do. So like that means if you explain the scenarios and interface building everything on your it's a tenant. You don't work on Eclipse. We will work on Eclipse. So like both the versions.
Eclipse tenant, you need to provide your user ID and passwords with that. So once you have this Eclipse, you give this URL, this user ID and this password to your Eclipse, then only you can configure the scenarios. You can deploy the scenarios, and sharing this user ID and password would be tough. I can share this tenant with you, but I cannot share my user ID because this user ID and password, it is attached to almost 8 different tenants. So and 8 different
I'm asking
Arvind, in what Sanat is saying is he is asking us to do a design time from our local Eclipse. When you want to deploy
Correct.
And see support, we will send the design time to him so that he will deploy on his tenant and show us what is output of every exercise. That's what he is trying to say.
Yeah, it's fine then. Fine then.
Yeah, because whatever the design time is same for you and Sanat, or me and Sanat, both are same. Only the thing
everything
is he is having the deployment option because he is having the server and tenant ID, so he can do the runtime. Okay. But if you want to see he is going to show what is going to happen in HCI and the tenant side. Only thing is, he is not going to give us an access. That's what I understand. Sanat, this
correct.
Is correct? My understanding is correct?
Yep, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And this would be Vijay.
Yeah, Sanat, this is Vijay here. Sorry, I couldn't unmute
okay,
myself to you. Sanat,
my question is... Who has stopped? Can you give the name to the trainer? Trainer will be...
I that is Shankar.
Shankar before I speak.
Okay, Shankar. Yep. Okay. Yeah, Vijay. You were saying something?
Yeah, so my question is like other cloud technologies, they provide a sandbox URL where you could create our user IDs and practice. So SAP did not provide any such environment where we could a standard URL where we could create our IDs and practices.
No sir. See, I would be very frank with you. Till December 2016, so 5 months prior to this, SAP was providing the test scenarios to everybody, the test tenant, to everybody who has the S user ID or the SAP ID. If you had those, you would just need to go to send a mail to hci.trial and @sap.com, and you would have got a trial access of your HCI for 1 month. But after the release in December, they have stopped giving the trial access, and now if you are a kind of SAP partner, implementation partner, then you can get the developer tenant for free from SAP. If you are an SAP implementation partner, if your company is an SAP implementation partner, then you can raise for the SAP HCI tenant. Okay, but for other users with only S user ID, you won't be provided with the trial access of HCI.
Okay. So now, Sorry, go ahead.
No.
Okay. In the current scenario, we install the Eclipse, and you would let us know how, what more drivers we need to put, or what are we going to do after I install Eclipse, so that we get the feel of it?
Yes, sir. For that I have separately one class to show you how to install Eclipse, how to download Eclipse, how to install the HCI plugins, and what configuration are required on your local, like your Java 9 or something like that. All those things I would be showing you. It's not today itself. Today we'll be taking the introduction class. I will be taking a little bit overview of your SOA if it's required, okay? And then we will be slowly taking the introduction of HCI. Okay, we will be not directly jumping onto HCI. I would say I prefer to take it slowly for people who are not from the integration background, because there are people in the call itself who are from the SAP database or kind of HANA database background. So I take it slowly. I don't skip things. Slowly I will take all the things, and this would be, I would try, like to student to have little patience, because some, if you are there, you have some have 9 years of experience in PI and 11 years of experience in PIPO. So for them, those things would be very quick to understand, very fast to grab. But for others, it would take little extra time. So I would say have little patience for that, so that I will, for them also, for other students also, that would be easier to come to the level where it is, the understanding is same.
And okay. So in the course content that you had shown, you had shown different adapters that HCI provides. So would you show scenarios where you use this, like Ariba adapter?
I would be showing the three adapters. I would be showing the SOAP adapter. I would be showing the OData adapter. I would be showing the HTTP adapter. The live scenarios. Okay. I would be also showing a little bit of SuccessFactors adapter. If you know the OData adapter, then your SuccessFactors adapter, it is just identical. I will be giving the overview of all SFTP adapter, or you have the Facebook adapter, Twitter adapter. I will be giving you an overview of that, but not the live scenarios. Overview as in what things are required to configure. Okay. And what all things would be required to do in this sender adapter or receiver adapter of both, for both.
Okay. And lastly, so in the real time, is this what you do? You develop your scenarios on Eclipse and then transport it to the your HCI URL. Is that what you do, or you do it everything on the your URL that is provided by your company?
Sorry, I didn't get your question. Sorry.
Okay. Here, when we install the Eclipse and the class that is required to do our practice scenarios, do you also do that in the real time, wherein you on the local machine you do your scenarios and can then transport it onto your test server?
Correct. I do that.
Okay. And can we test on the local server that we are going to work on? Can we test scenarios where SOAP to?
We cannot
SOAP to.
We can.
Can we test it end to end?
No. We cannot test it end to end. We can check if those are errorless or not, and if it's those are correctly configured or not. For testing those scenarios, you need, it's not like you have your PI where you can directly test your mapping there and there itself. Those capabilities are not there with HCI as of now. Okay, to test everything, you need to trigger a message. Okay, that is the only way to test a scenario. It's kind of, if you want to even test a mapping in your HCI, you have to trigger a message from the endpoint, whatever the sender and receiver, and then only your map testing would be done, as in contrast with your PI. So and that is only possible when you deploy those things to your cloud. Okay, without that it's not possible. So again, you can check if the scenario is correctly configured, if it is error free, and if there are no configuration issues available. But you cannot test through your payload, the sender payload, that if the message is passing correctly or not.
So I cannot use a SOAP UI to push the data to through this Eclipse wherein I have my configuration.
No, sir.
So what are we doing here actually? We're only doing the mapping, or what are we actually doing in this course? Only the iFlows?
Sorry?
So what are we doing in
this
course?
We will be, we will be completing all the iFlows, all the events which are available, all the functionalities which are available in HCI. We will be covering up all those things. Theoretically and practically both, but practically the fewer ones, let's say C4C, we have the ECC and we have the HCI, okay, but theoretically we will be covering each part. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions, sir?
No, sir. Nothing from
that. No, no. Other than that,
fine, sir. That's fine for us. So,
yeah.
every day, at what time we want to plan the session?
I guess Bharat should pitch in here. I would be, means for me, it would be 8:30 to 9:30 India time every day. Okay, which is okay with me. And on the weekends, it would be around 2 to 3 hours continuous, so that we can complete this session before, or means as soon as possible, faster than possible. If it's okay with everybody, if they are available, then we can take 2 sessions. Okay. Like, and it's 8:30
a.m. 7 to 8:30 is fine.
A.M.
7:30 to like now. 7 to 8:30, that is too early for you.
It's too, not early, but kind of, I would say there is an issue with my light, means my electricity. So there is possibility there is a power cut. So I don't want a sudden breakdown in the session. So it's 8, if I can even extend from 8 to 9, so it would be good.
Like, I want to check with Shankaran Pradeep. They are in US now. So,
sorry?
For them it will be late, I think. That's why I'm asking to them. Shankaran
Pradeep. For whom?
Shankar and Pradeep, they are from US. So, Shankar and Pradeep, they're both from US.
Yes, yes.
So, for them it will be late.
Yeah. It will be 9:30. Yeah. This is Bharat. Yeah. So it will be 9:30 p.m. to them. If at all the sun has joined at 8 o'clock in India time, it will be 9:30 p.m. to them.
Hey, we are in EST. It will be 10:30 for us.
Okay. Then I'm sending the CST. You are not seeing. Sorry, guys.
Okay. That's what I told. We just.
Sorry, guys. I thought that you are in the CST. Okay.
No, we are in EST.
Okay.
But it would be little tough in the logistic way also, because if even I've joined, it would be, if there's a power cut, then it would be a failure at that time. So if 8 o'clock it's sharp, we can start the sessions. Okay. And then we can end it by 9.
8:30 to 11:30, then
I am okay with that. So I want to.
Arvind, you are in India. They are in
India. Can you bit early?
Yeah.
At least half an hour.
That's what I'm checking with them.
11 also fine for me. I don't have any.
So good. Pradeep and Shank. That's fine.
Sanaji.
It would be a little tough, Bharat, for me because it's not the timing, but if light goes, then I would be